So this process that we're going through right now, would you describe it as hype?
Like this?
So is there a word that you use that you're like, there's no way I'm going to use that word in 10 years?
Probably it's when people say, like, that's lit.
Like, hype.
Oh, goodness. So, like, what's the slang? Mm-hmm. The other word I can think of is fried.
I'm going to Trinity College in Hartford, Connecticut.
I'm going to Cornell University.
I will be attending the University of Michigan.
I will be attending the United States Naval Academy.
I'll be attending Indiana University.
I'll be attending the University of Notre Dame this fall.
I'm going to IU next year.
I will be attending Belmont University.
I will be attending Vanderbilt University.
I'm going to Georgetown University.
I will be going to Notre Dame.
I'm going to American University.
And I'm going to Loyola Chicago.
I'll be attending Oberlin College.
I'll be attending Indiana University in Bloomington to study business at the Kelly School of Business next year.
What am I gonna miss about Brebeuf?
What am I gonna miss? I'm definitely going to miss the teachers and the community because, you know, and 4 years flew by pretty fast, but I felt like I got a strong connection with the community, and it's just kind of sad leaving it, but I'm kind of happy knowing that I was part of something so special here.
Well, I think if you had asked me this question a couple months ago, I would have first said the Jesuit values and everything, because a lot of the schools on my list weren't Jesuit. I had a few that were, and Georgetown obviously is one of them, but I didn't know where I was going. And so I was really sentimental about that part. Like when I was going to like the all of our convocations and things, I was starting to realize, like, oh my God, this could be like my last one.
Definitely like the people is the biggest one. I'm always like drawn to people instead of like things. So it's definitely gonna be like the teachers and the people that I'm gonna leave behind and classmates and students who still go here, like in other classes. So it's going to be the people that I'm going to miss the most. So.
What has made my high school experience special is the special bonds that you see between the students, the faculty, staff, and administration. And I wish that every school out there was like Brebeuf in terms of having those environments that are filled with love and concern for others.
When I think of a grade, I think of like 220 people coming together as one, not as 220 individuals just being out of school and walking across the stage. We're all walking across the stage together.
From now, so I'd have graduated from undergrad with a major in psychology, and then hopefully go into law school and study law and become a lawyer.
There are so many things I want to do, and I think Brebeuf has sort of helped me to narrow down those things.
In 10 years, I hope to be a resident in a hospital. My dream is to become a surgeon.
So if you have one piece of advice that you would say, I wish I knew when I was a freshman, that you can tell a younger student, what would that be?
I would say try new things. I was told that a lot as a freshman, yet I never did it until maybe junior year, and I realized that's something I should have done 2 years ago.
I would say, like, take in every moment, everything
you experience here at Brebeuf, whether it's good or bad, is gonna impact you, and it's gonna lead you to this place. Like, lead for 4 years from now, you're gonna look back and realize that every single little moment that you wouldn't think makes a difference made such a big difference.
I'd say just don't be afraid to get out of your comfort zone.
One of the things that my friends and I really enjoy the most is like the PRTs, and we sit around this circle table in the back of the cafeteria every day since sophomore year. And it's just the conversations you'll have during those times are really like, really have a big impact on your life when you go back and think about them. So enjoy small things like that.
Take it all in. Don't take anything for granted because it goes by so fast. I remember coming in as an eighth grader as well, just like Eli.
It's probably like sophomore junior year, I was walking in the hall and I was walking down the stairs and like I tripped and I remember like I fell on top of someone and I pushed someone else over and it was just kind of like this huge like pile of people in the hallway.
So I hadn't fallen down the stairs at all. Like normally you get scared like, oh man, I'm gonna fall down the stairs as a freshman. No, I fell as a senior.
And I didn't notice the stairs in front of me. So, you know, I fell down like a flight of stairs. And if you've ever been to Brebeuf, the stairs are just horrible here.
All of the answers so far have been stairway related.
You know, I don't trip. I don't really trip.
I'm most grateful for my family and friends. My family has supported me through everything. They've just been in there in any situation. Many laughs with them. And my family is just like something, people who I can rely on. And I can say the same thing with my friends.
First most, my mom and dad, because I wouldn't be sitting here today if it wasn't for them. Coming to Brebeuf wasn't really expected, so I want to thank you for allowing me to have new opportunities and just supporting me the whole way. I know there was some times where I wasn't the best, and I just want to thank you for always believing in me and supporting me and making me who I am today. I love you guys.
Thank you for putting up with me for the past couple of years. Sometimes it's tough, but it's been a fun time and I'm glad we could do it together.
Yo le agradezco a mis papás por todos sus sacrificios. No entiendo cómo dos personas pueden ser tan, pueden pensar tanto en otras personas sin ser egoístas. Les agradezco por todo lo que han hecho por mí y por todos sus sacrificios y por todas las horas que han gastado llevándonos a qué lugar o a cuál lugar. Y todas las horas que no han dormido y que nos han apoyado, les agradezco mucho, mi mamá y mi papi.
Thank you, Mom. You've done so much more for me than you will ever know, and I would definitely not have been able to come through Brebeuf without you. To all my sisters, I love each and every one of you.
I would kind of describe the senior class as just like a whole bunch of overachievers.
Yeah, it's really hard to explain in a word how our classes, it's just more of a feeling.
Like if I could kind of describe us in like a phrase, I would say that we are a weird summer camp. Because so obviously high school is, you know, like a 4-year commitment. But it's kind of like you have a bunch of different people who, you know, are connected and that they like live in the same state and are all kind of like probably generally from the same walks of life. But they also all just kind of happen to be here. And so you have to like make friends and figure out like who you like and who you don't like. Like you just figure out who you're similar to and like what you want to surround yourself with every year at this summer camp. And everyone's doing different things and like your interests are completely different. But at the same time, you always kind of have like bonfire moments where everyone like comes together and sing around the campfire, like talk to each other, even though during the day, all of you guys are doing these different things. And so then, you know, later when you are at an age when summer camp is no longer applicable to you, you will still remember like just kind of the big moments when you guys were all together and you'll remember that you were all at this camp.